this question. Thank you.
Thanks, Ken Carlin. Minister, can I really put it to you that your social housing policy is really a total shambles and a disgrace? You mentioned a figure earlier on there of 4,000 new social housing units, mostly through leasing arrangements where we're subsidising private landlords. That does not even half cover the increase, the jump in the numbers on the housing list, which is now up to 110,000 families and individuals, where it was previously 100,000 and before that it was 96,000. There's a sleight of hand in terms of the announcement of 30 million for 500 new houses. When you look at the figures in the expenditure report, you discover the other side of that coin is 15 million less for local authority housing, 15 million less for voluntary and cooperative housing, 2 million less for social housing improvement, and I can go on through the list. Now, I just want to ask a very simple question,
please,
Minister.
You're 1 minute.
According to your figures, 30 million euro equals 500 new houses.
I'll come back to you, Deputy. I'll come back to you. No, I won't come back to you.
Why can we not multiply that?
Can you see the clock?
Put 2 or 3 billion into building new social housing, save ourselves the rental house, house people on
the... Will you sit down? I'll come back to you. Deputy Minister, please.
Well, first of all,
will you watch the clock? Can you see your time?
Just point out a very simple fact that it takes quite some time to build a house. And, you know, if you want them all delivered next year, you're going to have to use methods like leasing in the short term in order to provide houses next year for people who are on the waiting list. Yes, we're starting a construction programme. We have finally stabilised the spending and we're starting to increase the spending. And I think that's quite a significant achievement considering that we're coming out of an economic emergency where capital budgets have been had to be cut over the past 5 years because of a previous government's actions and neglect of our country. But we are now near the end of it. We're coming out of the bailout. We have stabilised the funding. We've got some stimulus money with the assistance of the Department of Public Expenditure and Reform. We're starting again a general construction programme, which many of you have been calling for here.
Thank you.
Part of the delivery next year is going to be bringing voids back into use again, and I know there are many of them, particularly in the Dublin and Cork regions.
Thank you, Minister. Deputy Byrd.
It's getting worse, first of all, okay? The situation is getting worse. And I'm just putting a simple question to you. According to your own figures for the cost of building a new house, and we were building 90,000 houses a year during the boom, so don't say we can't do it in a fairly short time, to build 100,000 council houses, according to... To build 100,000 council houses would cost 6 billion. We would save 1 billion a year, 1 billion, according to your figures.
You said
30 million for 500 houses. 30 million for 500 houses. So 100,000 houses would cost 6 billion and we would save approximately 1 billion a year in rental allowance payments and in the extra rental revenue that come back to the state. On that basis, we could even get the money from the European Investment Bank because we would pay for those houses over a minimum of a 10-year period. And then we would be into surplus. And we would have solved the housing crisis, and we would have put building workers back to work. Why can't you do that?
Thank you. Minister.
Well, first of all, you're using fairy tale figures. If you think you're going to build that number of houses with that amount of money, I think you've another thing coming. Maybe Deputy Wallace might enlighten you on the cost of building houses.
I just explained that to you, but you weren't listening.
I explained the figure for next year is partially to do with bringing voids back into use, and you can do that a little bit quicker than you construct. Generally speaking, it will take you at least a year to construct a housing development. So that's why a lot of the money next year is going to be delivering through voids. As we move on, and we hope we'll get more stimulus money, we are developing and we will increase a house construction programme. But look, we are in a real world here where capital budgets have had to be shrunk. We are also doing an assessment currently of the waiting list. That waiting list is one that needs to be updated so we get accurate figures. But Deputy, I think you should be happy that we're finally spending a little bit more money while we were having to reduce it over the past 5 years.
Thank you. Thank you.
Question number seven, in the name of
Deputy John Brown. No, you can't. Deputy John Brown's question.